those orcas in the distance.
You can even see Mount Baker in the distance. On my way. All right. I'm making my way past Looming Island up this strait here. Going out that way.
I'm walking from Fossil Bay down this road, and it's just deep forest. It's very quiet. Heard a woodpecker a little while ago. I keep thinking bear, but there's no bear out here. No deer, just raccoons. Haven't seen one of those yet though. A little bit of a brisk walk, 60 degrees or so. Sun's peeking through. Pretty. Well, that turned into a couple miles of walking up and over the ridge. I'm on the downhill side now, walking into Echo Bay and Shallow Bay. I want to have a good look at those bays for moorage, see what's going on over here. I might just come over here for the night. Well, this looks like Echo Bay. And that looks like where we went before, through the fingers. Quite a lot of boats out there. There was a huge boat out here when I came in last night. Through the woods into Shallow Bay. It's not very big. It's pretty quiet in here. Interesting sandstone. As it turns out, there's two sides to Shallow Bay. This is the bigger side, to the north. No, this is to the south. We just came through that. This trail is kind of precarious. That's the beach down there. Trail goes right along the edge.
Thank you.
Alright, that's Fados. Sucia, back there. We're moving along. That's Canada. We had to cross the line here. Orcas Island, big mountain in the background. Waldron. Yeah, it's gonna be a little rough out here, but speed will help. Yeah, it's not too bad. 15 miles of wind. I'm reefed. I can drop this jib if I have to.
Phew!
Little rough spot ahead. I'll be right. Boundary pass. About to cross the line. I'm enjoying myself. It's a little stressful, but it's what I came here for. I'm gonna go across the line. Harbor seals back there. Potatoes, that's where I came from. This is Canada. Saturna Island. These are really choppy right here. Tides turn. Real choppy. Got to get around that point over there, and then the furthest one down there, and there's a little sail I can see down that way. That's where I'm going. Tender Island. Customs. Now that's the northeast point of Tender. So I got to get around that point. Big ship out there. Another one back over there. Easy sailing right now. Big beautiful house right there. Come a long way this morning. I'm gonna make it. Whether they'll have me or not is the question.
There's a train bound nowhere, its whistle called my name.
Hey, yeah.
It was a train with just one station,
now it's cleared up
destination,
a
my claim to fame. And I was riding on that one-way train with all my dreams locked away in my brain. I was riding. Thank you. But everybody always said to me, boy, your head is in the clouds. You're living in a fantasy. But for that I was so proud, 'cause I was riding on my one-way train with all my dreams locked away in my brain. There's a train that's bound for heaven. Its whistle calls my name. It's a train with just one station. Its destination is mine to claim. And I am riding on this one-way train. And when I am gone, I'll live eternal days. Lord,
you
Satellite Channel coming into Chute Passage. Many islands nearby. Back there is Tender, back where I checked in. Just missed this squall.
Iroquois Pass. Felt like we were moving along, but not really. It took a while to get through here. Just stayed in the middle of the channel and plodded through.
got rained on yet. Just coming in Sydney Harbor. I just got cleared. They got a spot for me. Out on the end of each dock. This will be interesting. Both hands. Alright, I'm tied off at 10 till 1. Port Sydney. With the big boys. I always feel like I'm the smallest boat around. But I'm not. There's somebody smaller. And then all along that long dock right there. This is where we are. This is where we'll be a couple days, I think. That's a hunter. 33. All right, we made it. Minutes out of Sydney. That's the city. And not really what I came up here for. But I had to see it. I'm going back to the States. There's a sailboat up ahead. He's going about where I'm going. Back to Roche Harbor to check back into customs. Over that way. Looking south, southwest, directly west of Sydney. A couple of kayakers making a big crossing. It's looking north. Great big giant ship out that way. Next stop, Roche Harbor.
We picked up a bit of wind on the way back to the US. We made a little over 8 knots. We passed through the channel with Forest Island to the north and Sydney Spit to the south, then continued east across Horo Strait, where we slowly caught up and overcame another sailboat on the same course to Roche Harbor.
Going right over top of a harbor seal. along at almost 8 knots. Stuart over there, speeding. Roche Harbor is up there somewhere. It's that island. Moving along. I got 8.5 knots here. Here's a reach over. Yep, moving right along. I'm glad I put the sail up. Finally got some clear weather. Yeah, this is fun.
Gotta watch out for this one. It's the closest one I've come across.
It's just a light chop, but it's really swirling on the rudder.
Right out in the middle of the strake.
Narrow Strait between Canada and America. In fact, I'm just now crossing the line back into the States. I came from way up there. I can even see Sucia behind there. For customs. Well, I just tied up Roche Harbor right here on the end, just for visiting. It's a beautiful place. Looks like it's grown a little bit since we were here last. And again, I'll be walking a long way, but I'm not going to stay here, I don't think. Got to go to Stuart and rob the treasure chest. It's easy coming in. Really nice sail on the way over. All the rich folks' boats. Stayed down that way. Thank you.
I see the sunrise creeping in. Everything changes like the desert wind. Here she comes and then she's gone again. And I'm just a traveler on this earth. Sure have my heart behind the pocket of my shirt. I just keep rolling till I'm in the day. Cause I'm a traveler. Oh, I'm a traveler. I couldn't tell you, honey, I don't know where I'm going, but I've got to go. Cause every time I review the song of the road, and I'm a traveler. Like the rubber turning on the ground.
Saying goodbye to Roche Harbor. I'm outside, there's the San Juan Island. So that way, around to the west, you get to Friday Harbor. This bleak looking island ahead is Speedin' Island. And I'm going past it. Just about where I'm pointing now, into the harbor of Stuart Island. Sunny day now. But there's no wind now. I'll just be motoring over there. I'll spend the night there. We'll take a walk this afternoon. Go up and raid the treasure chest. See if there's a dock space. Then I can take my hike up to the treasure chest. Really pretty over here. Oh, I think I just saw a big something come out of the water. Maybe a seal or a dolphin or who knows. Oh, that's harbor seal. Well, there's not too many people there. Spot. I don't think I'm gonna pay for a buoy. I'll just throw the hook somewhere. It's gonna be a quiet night in here. Hopefully it's warmer. It's been cold the last couple nights. Okay, Reid Harbor. Stuart Island, really pretty place. A lot of madrona trees. A we've been here. We harbored, we tied up on the other side and took a nap. I think we slept for 3 hours that day after walking this trail, which I'm about to do. It is 11:13 and I just put up sail. On the west coast of San Juan Island. I'm doing 6 knots, so I'm almost up to motor speed. And a great big salmon just jumped out of the water right here. Too bad I didn't have the video going. No sign of any orcas yet. This is right where we found them last year. Or the year we were here, somewhere in here, but no sign of them. All right, 11:23 off of Bellevue Point. I put the motor back on because my wind died, so I'll just keep motor on down the west.
south of the Bellevue Point, which is right there. Motoring on.
The seas have been calm all the way south along the west coast of San Juan Island. After rounding the southernmost point, we headed north back up into Griffin Bay. Our course was set for Fisherman's Bay, where I'd never been before, but always wanted to go. I had been able to put the sail up on only a couple of occasions, and I tried a couple more tacks in Griffin Bay before finally just giving up to motor sail in.
Fisherman's Bay. Real shallow entrance. Up again out here. It's just a real narrow entrance. Fisherman's Bay at 155. 1355. And tie it off. Pretty quiet. I'm gonna go ashore now and see what's up. Must be a restaurant over there. Pretty nice day. I came in and tied over there. Then I went and talked to those people, and that's not the resort dock. This is the resort dock. And I'm tied up way over there in the corner. You can see my sail sticking up a little bit. We're gonna go in here. Have a little lunch, a little sandwich. Leaving Fisherman's Bay. A nice fish sandwich. Fries. Nothing special. Yeah, it's better than motoring. Doing 8 knots. Heading over to Friday Harbor. Coming out of Fisherman's Bay. Great day to sail. Never been better. This is awesome. Big schooner over there. I'm heading straight for Friday Harbor. Nice tack. Long tack from Fisherman's Bay straight over. Little schooner right there. I'm overtaking. A lot of crap in the water I gotta watch out for though.
against a current again. Clouds have moved in, that's why we got this wind. Harbor over there. And I'm about to drop sail and motor in and call them. Give myself a slip for the night. A lot of debris out here in the river, out in the water. A lot of debris. Alright. Looking good.
Thank you.
Crossing Rosario Strait, we ran into the pods of orcas we'd been looking for. They were scattered along the western coast of Cyprus Island.
Decreed by Kubla Khan to taste my